Hi everyone, I'm Sean Berry, creative professional with over 30 years experience, and this is the second video in my new series, Learning Design from Scratch. If you are finding these videos helpful, please like and subscribe. If you didn't see the first video, you can check out this link right here, and that's kind of where you'll begin. If you want to know more about what this series is actually about or why I'm doing it, check out this video, and basically that'll tell you everything you need to know. So in video number one, we talked a little bit about what design is from a pretty sort of philosophical point of view, and also where design begins. And design tends to begin with an empty space, and we talked about that. Now, individually, we also talked about dimensions, space, language, visual content, and objects, and those as being the raw elements for pretty much any design project. And of course, we looked at doing one first initial assignment. The assignment was to take your photo and your name and to build a few shapes and experiment with what happens if you just try to combine them with no other particular guidance, just what happens when you put them all together. And of course, you tried this, I assume, if you're watching the second video. And if you didn't do the assignment, I would encourage you to consider doing them through this series, if you're serious about learning design. There's no better way to understand these principles than to struggle through the process of creating these things that at first may not look like great design, but just trust me, you're doing the right thing. So just as an example, of course, I did the assignment myself very briefly just to give me something to kind of connect with as I was going into this next lesson. You can see here that I've done some things. I tried some in more of a square format, some in more of a horizontal format, and I played around with those elements in relation to each other. Now, what's important to recognize from your own exercises, or if you're looking at my exercises, you pretty much have a couple of choices. You can do left, right, up, or down. You can put your name beneath your photo, beside your photo, above your photo, or over top of your photo. These are essentially what you can do with just a photo and just a name in a space of some size. Now, what's important to know about all of that is that we didn't actually use any design principles yet. And design principles kind of make a huge difference. Now, you may have heard this term design principles, sometimes also called design rules. Now, it's important not to confuse design techniques with design principles. So, what's the basic difference between a technique and a principle? Well, a design technique is something that you do, and a design principle is why you would do it. You can also think of it this way. A design technique is something you can learn in just about any YouTube video you find anywhere. For example, you might find a tutorial on how to crop a photo or remove the background, or to make a photo look like an old-fashioned photo versus a full color versus a black and white photo. Those things are all techniques, and you learn techniques by just doing more layouts. The more layouts you do, the more visual problems you solve, the more techniques you have. But a design principle is more of an idea about design, not a way to do design. Design principles help shape your design. They give you somewhere to begin, a way of thinking about what you want to achieve with your design. For example, working with the rule of thirds. Another big difference is that you can learn a design technique in an evening of Google searches and a couple of YouTube videos. A design principle is something that you'll be learning over your whole career, and you'll refine your understanding, and your understanding of them will deepen the more creative problems you solve, the more design work you do, and the more ideas you generate. Now, you might wonder, how many design principles or design rules are there? Well, there's no book, and there's no set list. You'll just find out over time what principles are important to you based on the work that you do. Now, you might wonder, if it's a design principle or a design rule, does that mean I have to follow it or I'm going to lose my job? No, there's no such thing as that. Design rules are there because they work. Design principles are there because they work. And all designers use them. And if you talk to 100 professional designers, they'll all say some versions of the same thing. Another way to think of it is that, when do you follow the rules? The answer, simply put, is always, unless the rule doesn't work anymore. And then you break the rule. But in order to break the rule, you have to understand the rule. And by breaking the rule, you should demonstrate your understanding of the rule. Now, that's a complicated idea, and I get it, and that's not going to be something in video 2, 3, 4, or 5 you're going to understand. So what are these design principles and design rules? Well, here's a list of some of the most common ones. It's not the whole list, it's not every design rule, but it's the basic ones that all designers end up using, even if they don't call it the same thing. Composition, balance, direction, flow, contrast, harmony, alignment, hierarchy, structure, clarity, weight, and continuity. Probably all of those words are familiar to you in other contexts, but they have a design meaning. And these basic principles show up in design work everywhere. And once you understand the rules, or understand them even basically, you'll start seeing them in design whenever you look at it. The other thing about design rules or design principles is that they are open to interpretation, but not a lot of interpretation. Balance can be described a few different ways, but the idea of balance is always consistent. Again, that's a lot to absorb in just the second video, but just keep this list in mind and come back to it as we move forward. Now, the really interesting part about design principles is that using design principles and learning them over time is how your design style will emerge. Now, before we dive into what each one of these design principles means, let's do the next assignment. And let's stay with the theme of a photo and a name. You can continue using your photo and your name, or you can find a photo of your friend that you like and use their name. You can use Tom Cruise's name and photo for all it matters. And the assignment is to do the following. Just pick one size. Don't worry about doing different sizes. You're going to pick one size that you like for now. Could be 1080 wide by 1350 high. That's pixels, by the way. If you remember from our first lesson, that's the Instagram feed size. That size isn't important, but it's a place to begin if you can't think of a better size to work with. You can work with that one. And take the same photo or a new photo, and take the same name or a new name, and look at each one of those design principles that I went through. And just do one layout with that word in mind, like balance, like composition. Now, you won't know what they mean yet necessarily. Some of you, if this is your second video in my series, and literally this is the beginning of your design journey, don't worry that you don't understand what I mean by balance. Don't worry if you don't understand what I mean by composition or hierarchy. It's only important that you think of the word and try something. Let the word of the design principle influence you, because I can tell you that the words do describe the principle. How to exploit that is something that'll take us a long time to uncover. But the idea of something being balanced, the word balance tells you a lot. And so just think of that and try some layouts for each of those principles and just see what the word influences you to do. If you're working in Photoshop, for example, be sure to name your layer based on the principle that you thought you were working toward. That'll be a fun reference for later. Once we get further down this video series, you can always look back and think about how you originally thought about these design principles and how your understanding changes over time. Do as many as you can, and I encourage you to do these exercises. Really, the practice is important. Do that. Come back for the next video, number 3, which I'll publish pretty soon. And we're going to start taking these principles one at a time and diving deep into them and spending a long time expanding what each one is and applying it to real design as much as possible, so that you're both learning how to actually do some design, and there's always an assignment you can play with, but you're also absorbing bigger ideas, and this will help you in your design journey. And hopefully it'll make designing fun rather than you just playing with things and not having an objective. Now you'll have a goal to actually exploit these features of design principles and start to grow your own understanding of how design works. So if you're enjoying these videos, be sure to come back for the next lesson in my new series, Learning Design from Scratch. Like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.